I'm on an expedition to Pennsylvania farm country.
It looks like the stabilized crossing is working.
I'm investigating how actions out here can affect what happens hundreds of miles away in the Chesapeake Bay.
Farmer selling his plot. Wow. That seems pretty counterintuitive.
The Earth is a water planet. More living creatures live beneath the waves than in our world above them. But our actions are creating vast underwater areas where nothing can live. These are dead zones. 400 dead zones have been identified across the globe so far. We are taking an expedition to explore these strange phenomena and to uncover what causes them.
I'm Philippe Gousteau. Join me for EarthEcho Expedition into the dead zone.
We began our expedition in the Chesapeake Bay and are moving upstream, tracing water back to its sources. Most of the water that eventually flows into the bay first falls as rain in rural areas.
For many people, farming is a way of life, and those who work the land provide a vital service, namely food, for a growing population.
In Lancaster County, Pennsylvania, people recognize the impact that nutrient-laden runoff from their crops and animals has on waterways, and they've begun adopting sustainable practices. This looks like a regular farm, so how is it different? I'm meeting up with farmer Bob Fox.
Farming here has evolved a little bit over the last decade or so.
Yes, it's changed from the way my grandfather farmed. In that we sold our plow and we do everything no-till.
A farmer selling his plow, now that seems pretty counterintuitive. Usually when you think of farmers, you think of plows. So in other words, you don't have a big plow going through and tilling up the soil, turning it over.
Bob is keenly aware of how farming practices impact nutrient loads in the waterways downstream. These nutrients are primarily nitrogen from manure and synthetic fertilizers utilized by many farms in the watershed. In the winter, this field is covered by plants from a different kind of crop.
We plant a cover crop, and if we look, we can still see the cover crop here. It's still there from the winter.
So you don't actually harvest this? This is, you just lay this down or go through and chop it up so that it sits on the field and keeps those nutrients flowing.
Right.
And then you go through and plant, in this case,
yes.
Soy.
And this actually acts like a mulch and helps preserve moisture or conserve moisture.
Soybeans look pretty good.
Nitrogen is a critical nutrient for plants, and the cover crop provides it naturally through the decay process, releasing nitrogen back into the soil for the soybeans to use. However, Farmer Fox does have to add some fertilizer to his crops. Where does it come from? Right here in the barn. Manure. Lots of manure. It's a huge challenge to manage for every dairy farmer. While it's great for crops, when manure gets into a waterway, it boosts the nitrogen levels, feeding the algal blooms that cause dead zones. But just like he has a plan for managing the nutrients in his field, Farmer Fox takes care in handling his manure.
It's a family operation, about 70 milking cows.
Milk isn't the only thing that comes out of these cows.
No, that's correct. yes, there is another side of it. The manure.
Okay.
Yes.
And that's part of the challenge that farms have in terms of dealing with that manure. What do you all do with it?
Well, we work with the conservation district and have a nutrient management plan and handle the manure in a way that we protect it from going into the water sources.
Bob explains that with careful manure management, he's making sure that the nitrogen, carbon, and other nutrients from the manure are put back into the soil and not into the water. The first step is to capture the manure in gutters behind the cows. Next, Bob turns on alley scrapers that transport the nitrogen-rich manure out of the gutters and into a fertilizer holding tank. Bob runs the scrapers every 24 hours because the gutters fill up fast.
Does it ever end?
It never ends. It just keeps coming.
Every year, Bob's cows make enough manure to fill the farm's 380,000-gallon slurry tank.
Oh.
Twice.
Boy, does it smell bad.
Nitrogen gas is abundant in the air around us, but transforming it into a form that plants and animals can use requires the complex processes of nitrogen fixation and nitrification. In productive ecosystems, plants are limited by the available nitrogen. However, manure is rich in nitrogen, so it must be managed to preserve ecological balance. In 2012, a little less than half the total nitrogen entering the Chesapeake Bay came from agricultural sources. Reducing this input may be the biggest issue facing the bay. Bob Fox is doing his part to prevent dead zones because controlling runoff doesn't just occur in the fields and the barn. He's also made changes to the pastures where his animals graze.
Kevin Lutz from the Lancaster County Conservation District is here with me to talk a little bit about some of the best practices here that are happening at Fox Farm. And actually, this is a perfect demonstration. The cows are coming right through, it's almost on cue. What's going on here, Kevin, that's so special about this place?
It's kind of a unique spot here. Bob's farm sits at the confluence of two streams that come together right at the corner of his property.
These streams feed directly into the Susquehanna River, which is the largest tributary of the Chesapeake Bay.
Right now we're standing in what's called a stabilized stream crossing. It's designed to force the cows to cross at a designated point, usually at the best spot in a stream that's going to cause the least amount of erosion to the banks.
So everywhere else, the stream is blocked off, except for right here.
Right.
That looks like the stabilized crossing is working.
The cows can still cross the stream, but they can't damage the riparian buffer of plants that line most of its shore.
So all these plants along this riparian shore zone absorb nutrients that could run off the fields from manure.
Right, not just nutrients, but also sediment.
Kevin is particularly concerned about nitrogen and phosphorus getting into the streams.
And that's because nitrogen and phosphorus are the same things that we find in fertilizer.
Right.
And fertilizers in the water can fuel an algal bloom and the dead zone that frequently follows one further downstream in the Chesapeake. Lancaster County may be far away from the Chesapeake Bay, but most of the water leaving here ends up there.
All of the farms in Lancaster County empty out into the mighty Susquehanna River, which is the main tributary into the Chesapeake Bay. Of course, agricultural pollution is the primary cause of dead zones around the world. And if we're going to create a lasting solution to that problem, farmers everywhere must adopt these kinds of best practices. Of course, each and every one of us can make a positive difference by understanding how our food is produced and making choices accordingly.
EarthEcho International recognizes that young people are making a positive difference in the health of our water planet. Watch as our expedition team joins youth from the Lancaster County Conservation School as they construct a log deflector. Go to www.earthecho.org to watch this and stories of others engaged in service learning initiatives in their communities.